In this section, I'm going to be showing you the profile landing page. Most of the information in this section is pulled from PowerSchool, therefore you need to make sure that everything is updated. If I want to make this screen a little larger, I'm going to click on the two arrows and enlarge this section. As you can see, you'll have the student's name, the school, the principal, their OEN numbers, as well as their SIA equipment will be pulled over, the student's exceptionality and placement. But please ensure that if a student has an IPRC, that you have updated this in PowerSchool. The next tab here is history. And when I open that section up, I can take a look at all the different edits that have been made. To make sure that I can change the status for my admin review, I have to make sure that down here, I have reviewed that I have updated and changed the accommodations for this term or semester. I have created a consultation page and that's been reviewed and updated. I have created a transition plan that has been updated. And I made sure that the strengths and needs match the IPRC documentation if a student has had an IPRC. If none of this has been done or you haven't created a consultation or transition page, you will not be allowed to change the status and it will prompt you to go to that page. But if all of these areas have been created and updated, now you're ready to change the status for admin review. You must put a reason, which is all updates have been completed, or whatever you would like to put that's important. You confirm, and now the IEP is going to be frozen for principal review. If you have made an error and you need to go back, that's okay. You go back to pending. You have to put another reason, updates required, or whatever information that you need to change or add. You can confirm, and this changes the status reason. Your principal can then see why you have removed the information or why you don't want them to review anymore.